In this video, we will learn to find values of other five trigonometric functions when tangent of x is equal to minus 5 upon 12 and x lies in the second quadrant. It's given that tangent of x is equal to minus 5 upon 12 and x lies in the second quadrant. We know the famous trigonometry identity square of tangent of x plus 1 is equal to square of secant of x. Plugging the given value of tangent of x in the identity gives us square of minus 5 upon 12 plus 1 is equal to square of secant of x. We know square of 5 is 25. Square of 12 is 144 and square of negative number is plus, so square of secant of x is equal to 25 upon 144 plus 1. Simple arithmetic operation gives us square of secant of x is equal to 25 plus 144 upon 144. Further simplification gives us square of secant of x is equal to 169 upon 144. Taking square root of both sides of the above equation gives us secant of x is equal to plus minus 13 upon 12. As x lies in the second quadrant, and values of secant function lies between minus 1 and 0 in the second quadrant, so secant of x is equal to minus 13 upon 12. We know reciprocal of tangent of x is cotangent of x. So cotangent of x is equal to minus 12 upon 5. We also know 1 upon secant of x is equal to cosine of x. So cosine of x is equal to 1 upon minus 13 upon 12, which is equal to minus 12 upon 13. As tangent of x is equal to sine of x upon cosine of x, so cosine of x times tangent of x is equal to cosine of x times sine of x upon cosine of x. Cancelling out the common factor cosine of x in the numerator and the denominator gives us sine of x is equal to cosine of x times tangent of x. Plugging the values of cosine of x and tangent of x in the above expression gives us sine of x is equal to minus 12 upon 13 times minus 5 upon 12. In above expression, minus 12 is the common factor in the numerator and the denominator. So, cancelling out the common factor gives us sine of x is equal to 5 upon 13. We know 1 upon sine of x is equal to cosecant of x. So, cosecant of x is equal to 1 upon 5 upon 13, which is equal to 13 upon 5. Thus, we find out values of all other 5 trigonometric functions. Thank you for being with me. I hope you like this video. Please click the like button and subscribe button. Do not forget to press the notification bell so that you get the notifications of my new videos. Share the video and do write in the comments. I am eager to listen to your thoughts. If you have any question related to the video or if you think I should make a video on any other topics in which you are interested, please write in the comments. Thank you.